Now, the last thing I'm going to talk about is an application of everything we've talked about. And we're going to be looking at what we call, what we describe as a conical pendulum. So imagine that you have a mass that's hanging on the ceiling and it's traveling around in a circle like this. When it's at rest, it hangs straight down. But right now, it's moving around in a circle. It's like you're swinging something around in a circle that's tied to a rope. So let's talk about the diagram for this. First of all, we know that it has weight acting on it and that it has tension acting on it. So what's really going on here is that the tension has a horizontal component that pushes it back into the circle. That's what's providing this centripetal force. And it has a vertical component that balances the weight. Oops. The angle that it makes with the ceiling is going to be equal and opposite to the angle that the tension makes with the X component. So let's say that we wanted to do an analysis of this. Well, first of all, in the Y direction, all of the forces are adding up to zero, so Ty equals Fg. And Ty is just going to be T sine theta, and that's equal to Mg. And in the X direction, all of the forces are adding up to push it back into the circle. And the only force that's doing that is Tx. So T cosine theta equals mv squared all over r. So I'm going to use this analysis to be able to figure out, for example, how fast it's traveling or how much tension is in it. So let's give it some numbers. Let's say that this mass is a 10 kilogram mass. And let's say that it's hanging on a string of length 1 meter. And let's say that the angle that it makes with the ceiling is 30 degrees. So if we wanted to figure out a few things that we would need for this, the first thing we would need is we're going to need to know the radius of the circle. And the radius of the circle is this distance right here. So let's draw a triangle of what's going on. We've got a 1 meter string, and we're trying to find this distance right here. Well, this angle is 30 degrees, which makes this angle 30 degrees. And we need to know the radius. So we need to know the horizontal component or the adjacent side. So we're going to use cosine. Cosine of 30 is equal to R over the hypotenuse, 1 meter. And so R is going to be equal to 1 times the cosine of 30. And so R is going to be equal to 0.866 meters. The next thing, what we want to do is we want to find in this situation what the maximum speed of the object will be and what the tension will be. So let's say that I tell you that this is swinging around at a maximum speed of 20 meters per second. And I ask you what the tension is. Well, first thing I'm going to do is I have to find the tension. So I could just use this formula right here if I want to find the tension. It'd be super easy, right? Actually, I'm not going to tell you. So let me just change this. I'm sorry. I apologize. Let's find the maximum speed and the maximum tension that this can exist at. So if all of this is true, we have two unknowns. We're going to find T and V. We've got two unknowns. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to solve for T over here. There's mg sine theta. And I'm going to put it in over here. So this is going to be mg sine theta is cosine theta equals mv squared all over r. The m's are going to go away. And so now I can just plug and chug. I can say 9.8 meters per second squared times cosine of 30 divided by sine of 30 equals v squared all over 0.866 meters. So v squared, if I add, put all these in my calculator, so cosine is 0.866. Sine is 0.5. I know that just because you do that all the time, but I could do it here. Let's move it over so we can see the actual formula. All right, so I'm going to take 9.8, going to multiply both sides by 0.866. I'm going to multiply it by the quantity 30 cosine. And then I'm going to divide it by sine of 30, which is 0.5. And so I'm getting v squared equal to 14.699. And now I'm going to take the square root of that. So the velocity would be, 3.83. And now I can go back. And I can figure out the tension, right? The tension is whatever the mass is. Well, I didn't tell you what the mass was. Didn't matter. But I could go back and find the tension up here, couldn't I? I could now go T equals MV squared all over R times cosine of theta. I could plug in all my numbers. But I still need to know the mass, don't I? So I did give you the mass. It was 10. I could use this formula or I could use this formula. It doesn't matter. I'm just going to use, I'm probably just going to use this one. So it's 10 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared divided by sine of 30, which is 0.5. So it's going to be 10 times 9.8, which is 98, divided by 0.5. So it's going to be 2 times, it's going to be 196 newtons. So it has a speed of 3.83 and a tension of 1.96. And that's conical pendulums. Let's do one more. We have a conical pendulum now that has a mass of 0.3 and a length of 0.7. And it makes a 20 with a vertical. Okay, so let's look at this. So if we go here, we've got FG, we've got TY, and TX. Now, the angle we used before was not this 20 degree. We used this angle. So let's look and see what the formulas would be for finding TY and TX using the 20 degree. The TX is now the opposite side, so it's going to be T sine theta, and this is the adjacent side, which is T cosine theta. So now, in the y direction, we know that TY equals FG. So that's T cosine theta equals MG. And T is going to be equal to mg all over cosine theta. And all we want to do is we're going to find the speed and tension in this problem as well. So in this analysis, Tx is going to cause it to accelerate. So T sine theta equals mv squared all over r. I'm going to substitute in my formula for T. Mg sine theta all over cosine theta equals mv squared all over r. The m's are going to go away. And I can reduce sine over cosine as tan. So this is going to be g times tan theta equals V squared all over R. And that's if we know this angle right here. Now, let's also talk about what R is. Here's our distance formula. We're finding R, and we know this is 20 degrees, and we know this is 0.70 meters. So now this is the opposite side that we're looking for. So we're going to use sine of 20 equals R over 0.7. If we put that in our calculator, 20 sine times 0.7, we're going to get R is equal to 0.239 meters. So if we want to find V squared is just going to be RG tan theta. Wow, it looks just like what we had before on the banked angle. That's crazy. So V squared equals 0.239 meters times 9.8 meters per second squared times tan of 20. And we put all those numbers in there. Okay, I'm going to do 20. I'm going to take tan of it. Times 9.8 times 0.239 equals, and then I'm going to take the square root of that. V is going to be equal to 0.923. And T is going to be equal to 0.3 kilograms times 9.8 meters per second squared divided by cosine of 20. All right, so it's 0.3. Let's clear everything out. 0.3 times 9.8 divided by the quantity 20 cosine. My calculator is stupid. Equals 3.1213 meters, newtons. And there you have it. So, we've done a lot of different problems here, and you should be able to draw the vector diagrams for all the situations that we've done, and you should be able to find the maximum speeds that those objects are traveling at and any tension or any coefficient of friction in those problems.